Hi, and welcome to the Markztools 8 introduction video from Markzware. I am Crystal Clerica, and I will show you the great features of Markzware's Markztools extension for Quark. Would you wait until your house burns down before you purchase fire insurance? Of course not. By then, it will be much too late. Markztools is an extremely valuable utility that serves not only as document insurance, but can often salvage corrupted document files. You can use Markztools to verify the integrity of your document before the precious original master file is overwritten, thus preventing an unwanted disaster. How to install Markztools? Quit QuarkXPress if it is currently running. Drag and drop the Markztools folder to a desired location on your hard drive. Copy the Markztools extension into your QuarkXPress extension folder. To obtain documentation, visit the Markzware page in our website. Download the manuals and obtain valuable information regarding updates. Upon initially launching QuarkXPress, you will be asked to enter your Markztools activation code. You can find this number on the inside of the Markztools package or in the confirmation email you receive from your online retailer. You can find the Markztools menu item under the Markzware item from the menu bar. Let's first have a look at the Markztools preferences, for they allow you to set up your Markztools as desired. Select the checkbox to instruct Markztools to verify the integrity of the current layout of your document project just prior to it being saved. If a problem is discovered, then your original document file on disk will not be updated, thus serving as a type of document insurance. Note that you can always turn this function on or off by selecting it directly from the Markztools menu. Select the Project Folder checkbox to instruct Markztools to create a temporary file in the same folder as the source document, or select the Other Folder checkbox and click the Browse button to choose a different location. Select the Verification Sounds checkbox if you want a special sound to be heard upon verification. You may also choose between high volume and low volume. The Always Force Save As checkbox will instruct QuarkXPress to always put up a save window whenever you save your document. This allows you to create a brand new, fresh file by giving your document a new name. Note that performing a save as from time to time can often compact or optimize a document file. Let's have a look at the other items in the Markztools menu. The Convert Document File menu item from the Markztools menu will present an open dialog, allowing you to choose the desired file you wish to convert. This should be your first option if you want to salvage a document. After selecting a file and before the conversion process begins, you will be offered a conversion options window, which gives you various choices you can use for converting the document. Checking Use Styles will convert all text stories by retaining their original character and paragraph style attributes. Checking Plain Text will convert all text stories using plain text. This method is the advised choice when trying to resurrect a bad document which may have corrupted style attributes. Empty Box. Use this option to convert the document using empty text boxes. This method, of course, results in a handy template. For handling picture previews, you can checkmark Use Picture. It will convert the picture previews in color as contained within the image or embedded in the document file. Choosing Gray Preview will convert all picture previews to simple gray. All links to the actual image files will be retained, thus allowing you to later ask QuarkXPress to update all picture previews to their original full color at any time in the future. It is always recommended you try this option when salvaging a bad document. Empty Box is the option to convert the document using empty picture boxes. Last, you can use the Layout menu to select the layout you wish to convert. An asterisk will indicate the document's default layout. Choose All Layouts to either merge all layouts into a single project or to activate and select Create Separate Projects. Select the Salvage Document File menu item to instruct Markztools to attempt to recover a corrupted document. Use this method if convert document is not successful. The Salvage function will bypass specific complex elements in the document, which individually could be corrupted. You can also select the Verify Document File menu item to check an existing file on disk. Sometimes, a document file has become so physically damaged that it might be very difficult to recover. A file might be physically incomplete and therefore absolutely impossible to salvage. In this case, Markztools will attempt to recover whatever portion of the document it can. In extreme cases where the document cannot be salvaged at all, your only hope will be to at least extract the text stories. To do so, select the Extract Text from Document File menu item and an open dialog will be presented, allowing you to choose the desired file from which you would like to scan, find, and extract text. Upon selecting a file, you will be presented with a scavenge text floating palette. For convenience, a new document window will be created for you and set up with an automatic text box and auto-page insertion set to end of story. This is so you can easily extract text and insert it into the text box of the new document. Enter a value into the Ignore Count Less Than box to inform Markztools that you want to skip finding text boxes only containing a small word, such as a page number. The next, Previews and First button will help you to navigate through the file and select the story to start from. Select Stories to instruct Markztools to locate text stories. You should try using this method first. If the Stories option failed, you can select Block in order to locate raw ASC2. Use this as a last resort to extract text from a damaged file. Note that this process will often pick up garbage data that you will need to manually edit out. Select the Extended ASC2 checkbox to avoid some of the unwanted characters found in block data. Apply. When you have located a story, you can click the Apply button to insert the text. Select the plus return checkbox to insert a return character before applying new text. The All button simply locates and applies all text stories found. Back in the Markztools menu, we can also select the Convert Image Previews to Gray menu item. This will set all picture box previews to a simple gray. This will make each preview size quite small and can drastically reduce the file size of the document. The Update Modified Images menu item will set all gray or gray picture box previews back to color, provided of course the image files exist on disk. Last but not least, you can select the Export Project to version 4 or 6 or the Convert Document File to version 4 or 6 menu item to downsave either the open file or a file you can locate yourself. A save dialog will be presented, allowing you to select the desired destination for your new version 4 or 6 document. Easy as that. Needless to say, when converting down to a lower version, many higher version features will not be converted. However, Markztools will attempt to convert some features, such as changing an object's shade to simulate opacity, or by creating an additional shaded box offset to simulate a trap shadow, or by converting a table so that cells become individual boxes, and so forth.
That completes the Markztools introduction video. I hope it was useful. This is Crystal Clariga signing off.